Brother, remember our revival.
April 2nd.
Okay? I think Sam's supposed to get some flowering things out. Call somebody this week. I mean, it's not going to start for the first week in April, but call somebody. Let's get this place filled out. Let's try to get here, and this is not, we're not coming. If somebody gets saved, that's a plus. If somebody gets filled with the Holy Ghost, that's a double plus. But if I get the blessings each night that I
need,
that's a triple plus. I'm coming to get revived.
Amen.
I'm coming to get something from the Lord. And I hope, and let's be praying. Let's be praying. Brother Terry Rigsby will be preaching the revival. I think most of you here know Brother Terry. He'll be preaching the revival. Starting the first week in April. It'll start on a Sunday night. And it will go through that week or until God says that is enough. Yeah, that's the way we want it. And, have you ever had one of those days whenever everything that you look at and everything that seemed to come your way was for God to make you to make a decision? Think about this. For God to make you to make a decision. This has been one of those days for me. And I look and I say, God, why am I having to do this? Why? And God speaks to me and He lets me know that He wants to be me to be obedient to Him. Hallelujah. He wants me to be obedient to Him. And you know, I think I can talk openly to the people that's in this church. I always felt that I could. And I always felt that you could come and speak openly to me if you wanted to. And this morning when I got up, I had to make a decision. Right off camera. And I said, God, why am I having to make this decision? And God says, I want you to be obedient to me. And I kind of laughed it off and I snubbed it off and I pushed it from one side. I thought, well, that's it. That's over. We'll have to worry about that no more. And it wasn't an hour later because something else come right at the end of my face. And I had to make a decision again. I had to make a decision. And I didn't want to make that decision. And I walked up to the church and Brother Ed met me. Brother Ed knows where I'm going.
Yeah.
It's no secret, we're not holding nothing back. And you know what? What happened to me right there, Brother Ed? God said, now you got another decision to make. God began to speak to me. He began to speak to me and He said, now I want you to stand with me. Hallelujah. I feel the anointing of the Lord.
Bless Him, Lord.
Yes.
Hallelujah.
Yes.
This afternoon, I thought, boy, I don't know what I'm going to do. It just seems like I've got a decision to make every way that I turn. So I went in there this afternoon. I told Wanda, I said, I want to go in and I want to lay down on the bed. I want to study a little bit. Hallelujah. Y'all might not be getting that out of this.
But you are.
But I've been in the presence of the Lord.
Amen. Yes, Lord.
I went in there and I sat down on the bed. I opened my Bible. And I begin to read, and I pick me out a sermon. I said, now I know what I'm going to preach tonight. I folded up my Bible. I laid it over to one side. I started to get up off the bed. The Lord spoke to me. That's not what you're going to preach. I said, but God, I've been studying this out. I've got this exactly like I know I want to preach it tonight. I said, what's coming? He said, you got a decision to make. I hope by decisions I make them to the Lord, I make them right.
Amen.
You know why? Because I'm a minister.
That's right.
I'm a minister. Jamie, I have no room to make no mistakes.
That's right. Amen.
This is in my ballpark.
Yep.
Mike, when you're out there preaching, you can't make no mistakes. When you're out there singing, Chuck, you can't make no mistakes. You got to have it right. I walked in the church, I thought everything was all right, and Chuck and I had talked several times about the gun, hadn't we? And I thought, well, hey, there's nothing wrong with that. I walked up on the roster tonight, hadn't paid no mind to it. Chuck, you don't care if me talking about this. No, you don't. I'm talking about decisions that have to be made. And they got to be made in the right way.
Amen.
Chuck and I have talked about this. We're living in a day right now that you never know what some idiot is going to walk in that back door with an automatic rifle or an automatic gun, Chuck, and go blowing people's heads off. And I told the Lord that just a few minutes ago. I said, God, somebody could walk in that door. Somebody could push through that door right there and come in and start killing somebody. You know what God told me? He said, this is my house, saith the Lord.
Amen.
This is my house, saith the Lord. He said, I'll take care of it. Chuck, I don't have to have a gun. Why? Because I got God.
Amen.
Hallelujah. The Bible says to be absent from the body.
It's present.
Be present.
With the Lord.
With the Lord.
Amen.
Not many weeks ago, I got a letter. And boy, it raked me up one side and down the other. I was a hypocrite. I was lazy, physically lazy. It wasn't worth giving. And I was telling people that the Lord was coming back.
I got blamed for it too.
And I was telling the people that the Lord was coming back. And I didn't need to be telling it. I was leading people down of the wrong road.
Yep.
I had a decision to make. And I want to tell you tonight, like I was telling you before I got the letter, the Lord's coming back.
Amen.
The Lord's coming back. It may not be today. It may not be in my lifetime. It may not be in that kid's lifetime. But it will happen.
Amen.
It will happen. And I'm going to try to get a head start on it, okay?
Amen.
I'm going to try to tell you tonight, before the Lord comes back, that He is coming. That He is coming. And if we need to make our calling, sure, we need to make everything ready. That if He was to take an ocean, not to wait 100 years, and to come back in the next few hours, or in the next few minutes, that you're ready to go whenever the trumpet sounds.
Amen. Yes.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
When that trumpet sounds, we're going to leave this ground.
Yes.
Hallelujah. We're going up to be with the Lord.
Yes.
Now, a lot of people have different things. They say, well, I'm going to stay here. I'm going to go through the tribulations. Go ahead. If that suits you, you go ahead and stay here. And you just, but my friend, I'm not going to be here when the tribulations come. You understand me? I'm not going to be here when the tribulations come. You know what I've done? I've made a decision. I've made a decision that I'm going to be with the Lord. I'm not going to stay here. with all the tribulations and the trials and all the stuff that's in this world, if I live 1,000 years, I'm going to see the Lord come back.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Now I'm going to make another decision. If you've got your Bibles, turn to 2 Peter. And I'm going to read a little bit tonight. And I'm going to tell you what I'm living in. And I'm going to tell you what you need to be living in tonight. Here's what I'm living in. I'm living in the hope of the coming of the Lord.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Jamie, I'm hoping that the Lord is coming back. I know He is, and I'm looking and I'm waiting for that time. If you got the third chapter of 2 Peter, turn to the third chapter, and we're going down to the 8th verse. Now listen to this and listen close. Now, you know, whenever I was a kid and growing up, and I know most of you probably felt the same way, if somebody called you ignorant, the first thing you want to do is fracture him right in the mouth. I'm not ignorant. The first thing you would say is, I'm not ignorant. But you know, over the years, I have come to the place that it don't bother me a bit anymore if somebody calls me ignorant.
Amen.
You say, what are you talking about? You got to understand what ignorant is. It's just not knowing. It's just not knowing. Now listen to this. But beloved, be not ignorant of this one thing, that one day is with the Lord as 1,000 years, and 1,000 years as 2 weeks.
What verse do you read?
One day.
One day. Now let's sum this up. I've been telling you the Lord was coming back. And I can't tell you what day that the Lord is going to come back. There's no way I can stand up here tonight. You know, I know preachers out there that's got their self going through and telling you the day and the hour that Jesus is coming back, that they've got away from the principles and the understanding of God's gospel. They have got away from everything. They want to tell you about the blood moon and all this other stuff that's going on. What difference does it make? I don't care if the moon turns to green cheese. I don't care what happens on this earth. Whatever is going to happen, it's going to happen, Jack. And there's nothing in the world that you're going to be able to do about it. Whatever is going to happen, it's going to happen. So you better get yourself to the place that you're not ignorant to the fact that Jesus is coming back one day.
Yes.
One day He's fixing the tape, and He's fixing to tell Gabriel, Gabriel, I want you to pick up the trumpet, and I want you to sound that trumpet as loud as you can sound it. And whenever He begins to sound that trumpet, something is fixing to take place like you have never heard of in all your life. You know what? It's not going to be a bunch of people left behind. What them that have made themselves ready, He said He's coming back after them that have made themselves ready. Them that have made themselves ready. You know, so many times we'll sit around and we'll let the devil put things in our minds and thoughts in our minds, and it's not awful careful. Have you ever been in school? You know, whenever I was a kid in school, we used to play a game. We used to play a game. His teacher would get it started. They started to front of the class, and they would tell some kid in the front of the class a sentence. Have you ever done this? And whenever they'd say, now you turn around and you repeat that sentence to somebody else. And whenever they had got back around to the end of the class, it was nothing to compare with anything that it started out with.
That's right.
See, the devil has got an endless form that he's got going.
Amen.
He has got something going that he can take people's mind. You know, we was talking this morning. We were talking this morning, enjoyed the Sunday school class this morning. Very much so. And we begin to talk about the things that the devil can use and how that the world, how the devil has formed so many different beliefs in the world. And he's got the world completely took apart with different kind of beliefs. Now let me tell you, let me preach you the gospel. For tonight, there is only one plan of salvation. Amen. Jesus came down on the cross 100 times. He didn't come out of the grave 100 times. He's not coming out again, and they will not crucify him not one more time.
Amen.
There's only one plan of salvation, and that plan of salvation is through the blood. Listen to what I'm telling you. It's through the blood of Jesus Christ. If you don't have that blood applied to you, you're in trouble. If you don't have that blood applied to you, and you're not a believer in Christ, you're standing in damnation this very night in front of the world. We've got to make our minds up to what it is that we need and what we want in our life. What's more important to you? The things of the world, the things of life, or is the plan of salvation the most important thing that you have in your life?
Amen.
You're not taking this world with you. If you think you are, I'm going to tell you tonight, you're not going to take it. You may leave it to some of your kids or somebody else. But Chuck, when you leave out of here, you're going the way you came in. You're going out with nothing. That's exactly what you're going to go out with. But the one thing, you're brought in this world with nothing. But spiritually, naturally, you come into this world with nothing. You go out of this world with nothing. But spiritually, you come into this world. You come into this world with something. You come into this world with something. The thing that we just pass by over and over and over, we let it go in one ear and out the other. You come into this world with a spirit and a soul. Mm-hmm. Hallelujah. Think about it tonight. You come into this world with a spirit and with a soul, and that thing is going to be with you from now on. Now you can push it over to one side, and one day you're going to stand before the Lord.
Amen.
Don't get out. You're not going to get out of it. You say, I'll get out of everything else, but you're not going to get out of this one. It's coming home. And what you're going to do, you're going to walk before the Lord with the only thing that you've got. Don't be ignorant. 1,000 years is a day, and a day is 1,000 years. Pastor Mercy. You're going to stand before the Lord. We're going to get out of it. It's going to happen. Get ready. Listen to me. Get ready. Get ready. You say, yeah, but I got plenty of time. You don't know what you got. You don't know what you got. But I've got this thing to do. I've got that thing to do. The most important thing in your life tonight is Jesus Christ. It's Jesus Christ and Him crucified. You know what? The world is going crazy. I mean, the other day I was, you know, you can turn your TV on. Every once in a while I turn my news off on Fox News. How many watch Fox News? Mm-hmm. I'm not running for Fox News tonight, but I'm telling you, they got the thing on the right line. Whenever they go out in the streets and they ask people, you can ask somebody, do you know who the President of the United States is? And that's down there.
Yeah.
Do you know who the Vice President of the United States is? I don't know. Whenever you look at them, they have no inkling of what God is. They have no understanding, none whatsoever, of what God is. But they was born with that one thing that you've got tonight.
Amen.
It was given to them. Somebody is not doing their job.
Amen.
Somebody is not telling enough people about Jesus Christ that know Him. Do you understand what I'm saying? That knows Him. Oh, we talk about the Lord all the time. You can turn on your radio and you can find out a gospel station of people that will tell you about the Lord. But they come to one height, right here. They can't get above that one height. They fuss over baptism. Because you're not baptized like I do, I'm not going to come and worship with you. Because you're going to hell anyway. Come on, y'all know what I'm talking about.
Yeah.
You know what I'm talking about? What are we doing? We've got away from what Peter wrote down. He said, don't be ignorant. Don't be ignorant. 1,000 days is as a day. And here we stand. The devil has got a whirlwind going. He's got a whirlwind going. And he's tickled today.
Yeah.
And there's a few people that stand by and begin to understand what it is that God wants us to know.
Yeah.
What God wants us to know. And we won't put everything that we got into it to try to help somebody get saved. I feel like I'm going to have to do something else that I don't want to do. I'm going to have to make another decision. I don't know what it is yet, but I'm going to have to do it. Before this night is over, I'm going to have to make a decision. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Yes.
Bless you, Lord.
I don't know why I'm having to do this all day long.
Bless you, Lord. Bless you.
But God knows what it is.
Mm-hmm.
It may not be with his main concern with anybody else in this building.
Mm-hmm.
May not. But how many was here the night when Brother Terry was by the morning when Brother Terry was prophesying?
Amen.
Amen. Amen.
Did God get to anybody? Did you understand what he was telling you?
Yes, amen.
I remember what he prophesied to me. And I hadn't even said nothing to this in my life. I'm quitting the church.
Uh-uh.
No, I'm not.
Yeah.
I
thought I was going to have to start preaching.
Because God prophesied to me, and he told me exactly. He confirmed what he told me when I walked on the stone, the parking lot of this old church.
Amen.
He stood and he... This week absolutely confirmed what God told me.
Amen.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord.
Amen. Thank you, Jesus.
I feel something.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah. I feel the anointing of the Lord. Hallelujah. Oh, I'm sorry, dear. I'm sorry.
Bless you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Praise your holy name, Lord.
Wait, Lord. Shannon, come here. I want everybody to get your mind on the Lord. Hallelujah. I told you tonight the devil was scaring you. He had a whirlwind going. Hallelujah. Keep walking. Hallelujah. Keep walking.
Yes.
Hallelujah. Don't stop walking.
Yes, Lord.
Hallelujah. 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 Father, thank you.
Thank you.
Hallelujah. 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 Thank you. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
By doing that, he reaches out to every other part
that whirlwind that's going around. I'm not saying my faith is bad, but I don't understand that the devil will use what he can to destroy and to tear down. This faith of mine is in that world. This faith of mine is in that world. I want that world to stay in me. Hallelujah. I want this world to stay in me. I want this thing to sleep right now. I want this kid to start eating. I want this kid to sleep. There are so many out there that are not this kid. But that's them. It's just him. Do you understand what I'm saying? He's not the rest of them. Why? He's not the rest of them. This is Kevin.
A demon from the fiery pit of hell.
Hallelujah.
Lord,
I want everybody that believes in God. I want you to get serious about me.
Take it, Spirit.
I want you to get serious. And I want you to ask God to touch this kid.
Touch him.
God, this kid, Lord, I want touch you to build a hedge around his baby right now.
Yes, Lord.
God,
the hedge
of people
that can't get under it.
That Satan or the devil can penetrate.
The branches and the limbs.
God, I want you to build it like that. Lift him up, God.
There is no way that Satan.
Oh, God, put your hand up on the captain right now, Lord.
That child,
God, let him feel.
Wrap him in your love and arms.
Let him feel that his little heart is desires, his fucking soul.
You're saying your only word.
God, let it happen right now. God, I rebuke Satan's trial. I rebuke the dark that comes before us.
And I apply this same prayer to him.
Touch him, Lord. Put your hand upon him. In the name of Jesus, God. Put your hand upon this kid right now.
Touch him, Lord, right now.
Oh, thank you, God. Thank you, God.
Thank you, Jesus.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah.
Thank you, Lord.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
Glory to the name. Glory to the name.